a few of you would have seen, there was a guy here who wanted so badly to be, part of a PMC, whatever, private security contractor, private military contractor, whatever you want to call it. He made his own company called PMC. And I can't remember his name was, which is funnily enough a girl's name as well. But and he says that he was an actress in his former life. But anyway, I saw this months back. This was back before I went over for my operation. It was back in September or whatever. I think maybe even before that, he went over to the Middle East and got captured. And they were saying that it was by a group of terrorists, whether it was ISIS or whatever, I don't know. But, there's video footage of him being held. He didn't really look like he was being treated that bad. They were just kind of holding him and going, what the fuck are you doing here? Who are you? And he said, oh, I'm a photographer. But on his blog and his sites and all that, he was always, dressing up like this sort of commando guy and doing all this shit and getting photos with different Defense Force people here in Japan. And then went over there to try and legitimize himself or whatever, or get some sort of training with real guns, and ended up getting captured. And now, after not being in the media for a while, because everyone's just like, fuck him, that's a general feel around with people around here. Whenever you talk to people around here about what's happened with that guy, just go, yeah, what a fucking idiot, deserves it. And I found it hard to have any sort of sympathy for him at the time, because I went, fuck, it's a joke. Hopefully the rest of you just fucking wake up, because there's a lot of guys that get into this cosplay, that play sabage, like this survival game and airsoft and that. And they take it a little bit far. They go overseas and they do all this training, which is fine if they're really that into it. I believe in gun safety and everything as an instructor of the NRA, pistol, rifle, shotgun, and also teaching other forms of firearms as well, including tactical stuff. But look, there's guys that do go too far with it, there has been dramas here, there has been shootings. So there's always that sort of balance. So this guy's gone over, got himself captured. There was another dude that went over who was actually a legitimate photographer, apparently, who's gone over to, he said that he was going to rescue this idiot, and he's got himself captured too. Now the two of them are going to be beheaded by, I think, executed, whatever, by tomorrow, if the Japanese government doesn't pay $200 million, okay? Now, there's been people captured in the past here, as in Japanese people, and held at ransom. Sometimes have been let go. A couple of people have been killed. Sometimes the Japanese government and or other companies have paid the ransom. Sometimes they haven't. So I don't really know what's going to happen. I guess we'll find out tomorrow. But I do feel sorry for the guys who have been caught, especially the one that went over to help this guy. As I said, I felt very a huge lack of sympathy for that guy that got himself caught in the first place, but I didn't think anything bad was going to happen to him, I guess, at that time. So I don't think it's cool for anyone to get themselves in trouble like that. I think it is a very serious situation. Shinzo Abe, the Prime Minister here, has vowed to save them and whatever, but for me, as a taxpaying resident of Japan, I would hope that even if the excuse was that, we don't have enough money, as in the government, well, all these politicians who are fucking loaded, getting ridiculous amounts of money, they can do sweet fuck all throughout the year, compared to what they say, could put their money together and help these guys out. Do you know what I mean? There's that many people that have spare cash to splash from the top 10 companies around here in Japan, the politicians, the religious groups that make a couple of billion dollars a year. $200 million is nothing, okay, if they really wanted to save these guys. But I would, my idea, this is in a perfect world, after getting that guy who was the idiot sent back here, would make him do something for the community and change his ways and try and make a positive thing, try and use the guy in a positive way. He's probably going to need some help after that. But I'm just saying that I think that what he was doing was promoting something that wasn't positive, because if he was going over there and doing that, all of his little followers and whatever are going to say, oh, that's cool, I'll go do that. Now, obviously, they're going to go, holy fuck, he's been captured and maybe tomorrow executed. Now, again, not making fun of that situation, I do actually feel a bit of sympathy for him now and try to be compassionate and all the rest, as I said. But, whatever situation you get yourself into, you got yourself into. And that's the harsh reality of it. So it is quite sad. But I hope the Prime Minister does something about it. And, yeah, my opinion or my plan is a perfect little world plan. Probably isn't very realistic. But that's what I would hope would happen. You know what I mean? They get the money together and don't say, oh, well, yeah, we don't have enough money. Do you know what I mean? Because you can't put a price on life. regardless of what an idiot they could be. You know what I mean? You could still be turned, as I said, and the guy could come back and have learned a life lesson and do something positive, start working with the people of the north, the Tohoku people, who have been affected by the earthquake and tsunami, for example. So I'm just hoping something positive comes from it all. I hope that no one is hurt beyond what they already have been, and I hope that it's all resolved. But that's the situation as of now. Again, we'll find out tomorrow, but by that time, it's probably already happened and you're watching this video after that. So anyways, thanks for watching, and if you haven't already subscribed, check us out on Facebook and Instagram, and as always, rawcombat.com, and your gym will fight here.